Sairam, Sairam, my humble pranam to Bhagwan and to all the elders, to all the friends, if they're there, they have recognized me, to sisters, brothers, younger ones, the souls who are present here. Sairam to everybody, naman to everybody. My journey with Bhagwan, first I thank my father who had introduced me to Bhagwan. 1961, Swami had, that time the war was happening. He was hit actually, and Swami picked him up and took him to hospital. When he gained consciousness, he ordered the jawans, "Walo wala aadmi ko leke aao." They couldn't find one. Anyway, many years after that happened, the whole incident happened. His journey is totally different. But then, Shakshat Roop mein, jaise hum bolte hain, like, no, we came to know about Bhagwan 1974 through, again, one of the colleagues of my father. Those days, we were in Kolkata. And my father and mother used to pray, and they used to do this 108 mantras of Kalima, and every morning we used to see lots of ash, and we were very upset. My mother was very upset. They used to wonder, like, what is this happening, because we were not aware about Bhagwan, how his blessings is happening, how he's indicating you. So he shared this whole incident to another friend. And the friend to friend, it went on. So that captain, he sent Papa one small photograph with Vibhuti. That is the day we came to know that those ash was actually Vibhuti. They connected my father, "Can we come down?" He said, "Okay, fine, come." So the moment they entered our house, auntie said, "He's here. Where is your puja sthan? Can I go and meditate?" So my mom said, "Okay, fine, not a problem. Please," because we were ignorant about all these things. That was the first time I realized that these lords of lords. She went inside and started the meditation. After 5 minutes, the whole atmosphere changed. We were all sitting next to that room. We could see Vibhuti dots every, it was a layer, like it happened during dawn or mist, small, small layers. We could see that coming out. I happened to, be in love with Jesus, Son of God. So for me, that person was very good, like, he's God, because those days, then Shiva was there. But this was the first time I realized someone more powerful is there, someone more, the instant contact we can have actually. So when these Vibhuti layers were coming out, I was a little kid, very small, and all I could see, something is coming out from that room. We all went inside. It was an ah moment for us. It was beyond thinking, like, every single moment, even if I think as on day, I go numb, because just to witness that moment, that the layers, the whole room was filled with Vibhuti. She said that, "Just pray that, you guys are very lucky. You don't know, you don't realize." That is the day I realized Bhagwan, he's omnipresent. You just have to call him. You just have to address or say or talk. So I had the small photograph. Those days, that is how my journey with Bhagwan started. I understood that he is big time, very powerful. No matter what, he was a very powerful man. I can reach him any point of time. Like this, many years passed. My father's posting happened to Sri Ganganagar, Ahmedabad, then Sri Ganganagar. Sri Ganganagar, because of heat stroke, I was diagnosed epileptic. It was a very tough childhood, in fact. I was unconscious for almost 13 hours. And Baba, like, you know, during that time, it seems Bhibhuti had come. And my father took that Bhibhuti and put it in my mouth. And that is how I got up. But you know how Swami's Leela is very different. My epileptic style was very different. Swami ensured that epileptic was happening only during night time. And I was normal during the daytime, which was blessing, big time blessings. And like this, many years started going on. I used to have Vibhuti every single day. From Sri Ganganagar, we went to Chandigarh, Delhi, and then Chandigarh. The whole journey was very, I was very conscious about so many things. I was very sensitive to new environments. I was very, you know, suffocated in many different ways. Chandigarh, this is 1991, where another turning point happened. I told mom that I am done with all the medicines. I used to take 4 mesitols to stand and 2 luminols to shut down my brain. I told mom that I'm going to stop all this medicine because I really don't want. I don't have a normal childhood. I'm very different from others. So my mom said, Swami ko bolo. He will cure you. I'm very grateful to one uncle. I want to name him Vashisht uncle and Kapoor auntie in Chandigarh. And they are there still. Vashisht uncle had introduced me to meditation, Jyoti Dhyana. He told me, beta, you do dhyana and see how meditation heals you. Little did I know that what mantra he had given me. No mantra, nothing basically. He just said the word meditation and Jyoti Dhyana. He taught me how to do it because Nagasankritan, morning Nagasankritan, you all used to do Jyoti Dhyana as a practice. But I started every single day and that is how the vibration, the healing started within me. One fine day, I just talked to the photograph. I said, Swami, sabhi aapko Bhagwan kehte. I don't know. I know you are someone very powerful. I've met you. I've seen you. But this is something I want a gift from you. I stopped all my medicines. I don't recommend this to any people who are not, you know, not having a good health, but definitely that was my call to do it with myself. And I stopped all the medicines and I kept it. Every single day, mom used to come just to give me medicine. I used to put it in the drawer and keep it aside. One fine day, that was 11 o'clock. In army house, there are 3 rooms, like, you know, because the Jawan used to come inside. So I was given a separate room so that I should lock it and sleep. That's a, you know, just a safety guard. We all do it. So that day, around 11 o'clock, I started hearing a lot of, you know, noise in my brain. As if some bottle, you know, just some, like how you wash it, the bottle. So I thought maybe time has come. I have to go to Lord now. So I just switched off the light. I kept myself very peacefully bed. And I said, Bhagwan, if you want to take me peacefully. I shouldn't fall down. My hands and legs will break. Somehow those things were also there. Suddenly I see this big fireball. I thought that's a Yamraj. Okay, that's a new style of Yamraj. Maybe we don't know. I have never heard because in pictures you say we see a mustache wala Yamraj. So I understood, okay. I kept on crying. I said, Swami, just take me peacefully. And those noises went, it was so loud. I can't even explain you. Morning, my mom came. She gave me a whack. How dare you open the door and sleep? I said, what are you doing in heaven? I'm in heaven now. So she said, what happened? Then I just hugged her and started crying. Her interpretation is, you're okay. Cure ho gayi hai. don't have to worry, you're cured. Go to Swami's mandir, pray. That is how, like, I started praying and I thanked him. 1991, I went to Bhagwan Dhaparti. Such a beautiful smile he gave with Vibhuti, which took my another life in a different turn. Coming to meditation. During meditation time, Jyoti Dhyana, I don't know how many you have done. I would love to have a good interaction if you guys have been doing meditation. The kind of vibration, the kind of each particles, we have energy. There was one point of time that I healed myself that way. Every single day I used to talk to myself. I'm just cutting before I go to the meditation zone. I used to get up, Kragriva Sati Lakshmi, those prayers we do it. And I used to bless myself. I used to look at the hands and I used to touch my all the body part and say, you are strong. All the powers you Bhagwan has given you during night time, I bless you. I keep on sending blessings to myself so that I reprogram myself every single day that something good is happening, something new is going to happen today, something new I'll be learning today, something new I'm going to experience of Bhagwan. So each day was my target to get something new from Bhagwan, probably in some new zone. So those days, this meditation was happening. So each day, something new. During Jyoti Dhyana, Bhagwan used to show in the flame. Many must have seen. But there was one point of time that was another ah moment for me. When I closed my eyes after half an hour, I could see the whole room lit. It was 1,000 volt light. Each particles had their energy. Each particles. It was so beautiful. When I opened my eyes, it was black dark. Only one diya was right in front of me. I closed my eyes. Every single, it was so beautiful. It was so beautiful. Just to experience that, it took me in so many years. When I was experiencing that, I went into different zone of bhakti. I knew God was there. He's there 24 hours. Every moment He's there with me. Every second. We just have to understand that He's there. The love, His kindness is. During that time, my mom stopped me, my meditation, but I'll tell, I always recommend not to stop if you, because I never knew, I was hardly 20, 21. I didn't know how to channelize my energies. I talked to Ashish uncle. Uncle said, no, carry on. My mom says stop. So there was another, but then I took my turn to Bhagwan. I went into a seva zone. But yes, meditation is very powerful. If you do meditation every single day, you end up blessing yourself. When you understand the power, because you're the source is there, but the source is sitting inside you. If the source is sitting inside you, he's blessing you through and through. It's just you have to have the trust level. I don't know how much time we have. I'm sorry.
You please carry on.
So when, thank you, just let me know because I don't have a timer here.
Don't worry.
So when the source is inside and we are talking to source, they are all one. It's just, Swami also has said that I know I'm God, but do you know you're God? So that is the area we all have to ponder on. We all have to trust the source sitting inside us. And, he's there inside you. Once you make friends with him, once you make, the love, your total, your complete surrender, miracle happens. And apart from that, the vibration, especially, this is my mother's teaching, that whatever you do, you be very careful the kind of vibration you share or you send across to the universe. During those days, I realized the table you have, the curtains you have, everything has a light, everything has an energy. So if you bless those energy with your own vibration, they also end up blessing you. There will be so many stories. I can't, there will be so many chapters actually. That is one area where Bhagwan did a turning point. There was another area. With my Balvikas children. This is in Chandigarh. In Delhi, I just did very few days. I couldn't because of my professional commitment. But in Chandigarh, I had around 35 children. And they were from, how the kids are. There was a couple. The father used to drink. I don't know, I should take their names or not, I don't know. And they used to, uncle was little different type, very aggressive. Their children was hardly 3 to 4 years old. And I had made this rule there that each Balvikas, they used to come to my home. But I had one, every week, one bhajan will be in each children's house. I don't know if it is here in practice or not, but I used to ensure those vibration going to each house. So that day, these two little kids, they had only learned the Ganesh bhajan. The bhajan started. In between, they realized they only knew Ganesh bhajan. Out of way, they started bhajan. You will not believe. Bhagwan's left eye, all the bhivuti started coming. All the children were, they were crying. It's a big joy for me also that Bhagwan blessed them. And jinke ghar mein bhajan ho raha tha, today they are like one of the very senior most office bearers. So that is like how we understand. Like if you take bhajan, if you take children, of course, bhajan, apart from bhajan, when you talk one-on-one, what kind of energy you are sharing, what kind of talk you are sharing, it's not only shloka or only this thing, it's overall. So that's the, when they had gave me a farewell party, it was very touching. It was very, all the kids are now grown up, but they are still in touch with me. I'm very happy about that. Began another episode. This is my brother who's in army now. He had a, ear drum was, some pus was there. We had taken to army hospital. My father had taken, this is in Kolkata. And they said that it has to be operated. My brothers, it is a family thing, so obviously. Why I'm sharing all this is beyond science, so obviously the whole thing is very, when doctors are also involved. So doctor said that his brain will be it will be affected. Tomorrow morning, I'll do the operation. So today it's going to be like, you stay in hospital, army hospital. So he sent Baba a vibhuti. He was very little. He says, Baba, get me vibhuti. I'll put it in and let's see how Swami says. Whatever instruction, if the vibhuti has healed inside, whatever it happens. So he had put some vibhuti. Doctor came, he said, what happened? Why this ash is there? Why you have done all this thing? We don't believe in all this thing. So he said that, no, I believe. You have also have to believe. So he showed that, okay, show me what is the vibhuti? So he said, you taste it, then you let me know that if you liked it or not. He took the vibhuti. I don't know what happened. He said to my father, hold, we'll not operate. We'll wait till tomorrow, 24 hours we'll wait. Night, as usual, in army hospital, they don't let any parents stay back. You know, they're very strict about the whole thing. Ma came back. Next morning when Ma goes, my brothers are seen. Ma, where were you? You took long time in toilet. So whole night, Swami was there with my brother. When they had picked up the pillow, there was vibhuti, there was little blue flower, there was one small gendika flower, and small, I think it was rice or something else, very easy. Doctor came, took the x-ray, nothing was there. So that is how Swami takes care. Swami is very kind. It's just you have to surrender. You have to understand what he wants from you. You have to be very careful with your words. You have to be very careful with your thought process. What kind of vibration you're carrying. No dvesh, nothing. If it is a duty to do, definitely if it is a duty to do, you have to do. That is different. But in your vachan, in your swas, he should be there 24/7. Sayra.